The University of Wisconsin-Stevens Point Northern Aquaculture Demonstration Facility introduces the Walleye Video Manual, a series of instructional videos on intensive culture.
Video 10, Purging Techniques and Critical Point Summary. This is the last and final video of the Walleye Culture Video Manual. The final steps before the fish are sent to market are some of the most crucial steps for food fish aquaculture. These steps can ensure freshness, flavor, texture, and overall visual appeal of the fish and fillet to the consumer. Ensuring the flavor profile of the fillets is ultimately the main goal when purging fish and preparing for harvest. Products with a musty or earthy off flavor is often rejected and can cause consumers and seafood retailers to subsequently avoid the product, which can have a devastating consequence to the producer. This earthy flavor comes from a chemical compound known as geosmin. Geosmin is the secondary metabolic product of a certain type of bacteria, in which the fish primarily uptakes through the gills. Thus, geosmin can also be diffused out of the gills upon transfer to a clean water system with lower concentration of the accumulated compound. In aquaculture, this physiological process of geosmin transfer serves as an advantage to reduce the earthy off flavor and is referred to as depuration or purging. Currently, the recommended practice for purging is to take fish off feed, transfer to a separate, clean depuration system if available, and provide the fish with flow-through or single-pass water flow. Lowering the water temperature during purging will also assist in firming the flesh. At UWSP-NADF, the temperatures are slowly lowered down to 7.6 degrees Celsius, or 46 Fahrenheit, which is the facility's well water temperature. Walleye take a minimum of 2 days to be properly purged based on water quality factors and taste preference. It is recommended to fillet a few fish to test flavor before harvest. If any off flavor is noticed, fish should be purged for several more days and then tested again. Once fish are purged, they can be harvested following approved practices to euthanize. The fish can then be sent to be processed following protocols to preserve freshness, quality, and food safety measures. Processors of fish and fishery products must be compliant with FDA to develop and implement Hazard Analysis Critical Control Point, also known as HACCP, systems for their operations. The final portion of this video manual includes several critical points to consider when investing in a new species, system, or aquaculture in general. The first point is do your homework. Before pursuing a new species, system, or aquaculture in general, it is important to fully understand the species of interest and the system in operation. This includes becoming involved in aquaculture associations, conferences, events, visiting existing operations, and finding the resources available to you. Pre-plan. Developing a strong and well-defined business plan, marketing plan, and biological plan is crucial before any investment in new species or system. Hire an experienced design team. RAS systems are very complex that require a proven design for aspects in engineering, water treatment, biological, electrical, and more. It will save both time and money in the long run to hire an experienced design and engineering team working with a biological consultant on the species being raised. Take baby steps. It is better to first test out a smaller system as a proof of concept than to invest in a large, extensive system. This is especially important to understand how your fish will perform in individual systems and to better understand surrounding markets. Hire qualified staff. Finding facility managers and technicians that have prior experience and education in aquaculture is one of the major limiting factors to aquaculture businesses today. Staff that are involved in daily operations such as feeding, watching, and managing the fish in the system are generally the first to recognize problems and to help prevent future issues. enhance biosecurity. Keeping fish healthy not only saves money from investing in antibiotics, quarantine, or other remedies, but also promotes optimal growth and feed conversion ratios. Good biosecurity practices mentioned in this video include foot baths at all entrances and exits, hand washing stations, disinfection of equipment after use, separate equipment used for each system, and only import disinfected eggs into the facility if possible. Each facility should have a written biosecurity plan, which each staff member is aware of and practices on a daily basis. In addition, it is important to acquire and work together with a fish health veterinarian to schedule regular fish health inspections and be able to consult with if fish health issues arise. Keep good records. Facility data should be recorded on a daily basis and be easily accessible to staff. Depending on individual facility protocol, this can be water quality measurements, fish sample data, feeds and feed ratios, any observations on fish behavior or system operation, and any changes or updates made to the system or other current daily system regime. This data is used daily by staff and also to determine overall system and fish performance, bioplanning, and future decisions. Have an emergency action plan. Being prepared and having action plans for various situations can be the difference between losing a few fish or the entire population. Backup capabilities such as a generator, additional or backup pumps, and additional oxygen and lines for individual tanks will be needed. A 24-hour call-out alarm system that will notify a response team at all times is critical. It is also important that all staff are aware of the emergency action plans and practice the steps to take for when this action is needed. This concludes the walleye culture video manual. In summary, walleye and sagai show to be a promising species for aquaculture in the Midwest. Intensive production methods can provide alternative markets for not only food fish production, but also availability of intensively and pellet-reared biosecure fingerlings for aquaponics or RAS facilities. Future research is needed for production of a captive walleye broodstock for year-round egg availability, as well as investigation of optimal feeds for the larval, grow-out, and broodstock stages. UWSP-NADF continues to research and develop best management practices to support the commercialization of walleye and sagai with various partnerships. Currently, the UWSP-NADF is the leading research facility for the intensive production of walleye and sagai for food fish production. Those interested in walleye production are encouraged to connect with the UWSP-NADF. Tours are free of charge and available upon request. For additional updates on research, publications, future work, and collaborations, please subscribe to the UWSP-NADF newsletter. This information and more is provided at aquaculture.uwsp.edu. Support for this video culture manual was provided by the University of Wisconsin-Stevens Point and the University of Wisconsin Sea Grant Institute.